Super Doppler 4 HD weather forecast.
Well, it's been cold the past few mornings, and this morning not as bad. We dipped down to 42 degrees in Greenville, 37 in Spartanburg, 36 in Anderson, and 34 in Asheville. We have had a freeze in many areas north of I-85 in the upstate and the North Carolina mountains. So the growing season over, also the ragweed season over. Your allergies should be getting better and better the closer we get here to November and get some more killing frost and freezes. All right, today was a warmer day than we've seen here lately. 74 the high in Greenville, 72 from Spartanburg all the way up to Asheville. A nice day outside, and we're going to continue to keep that warming trend going into the weekend. Hilton Greenville SkyCam showing that sunshine out in full force at 72 degrees with southwest winds at 5 miles per hour. Now, as we head into the overnight hours, don't expect temperatures to be as cold. We're still in the lower 70s across the area, right at 70 for the North Carolina mountains. We will slowly cool under dry conditions. Live Super Doppler 4HD dry, and overnight expect those lows to fall to about 10 degrees warmer than we have here recently. 52 the low in Greenville, 47 for Spartanburg, 45 the expected low in downtown Asheville. For tomorrow, we will warm up quickly. While to be chilly first thing in the morning, we're already some 20 degrees warmer by 11 o'clock. We're into the middle to upper 70s by tomorrow afternoon in Greenville. In Spartanburg, look for loads of sunshine, 66 by 11 o'clock, 75 by 5. In Anderson, 47 degrees first thing in the morning, warming up to the middle 70s by the end of the day. And in Asheville, you too will be warm. We're talking lower 70s by the afternoon with loads of sunshine. Expect those high temperatures to be quite a bit warmer than we had today, about 5 to 10 degrees warmer. Middle 70s across the upstate, lower 70s for the North Carolina mountains. We're tracking clear conditions right now across the southeast. However, a different story back toward Texas. Look at this system. We've got a low pressure right here over New Mexico, sending in severe weather for them. Severe thunderstorm warnings and tornadoes possible out that way. This is going to grab some Gulf moisture, which you can see down here in the Gulf of Mexico, and just douse Texas with flooding rainfall over the next several days. 4 to 5 to even 6+ inches is expected over that way. That system will later affect us to a lesser extent. We're expecting showers out of it early next week. Here's what's going on. We're going to watch for a cold front to slowly get our way while Texas is getting soaked. Look at all that rainfall continuing for the next 48 hours into Friday, finally coming to an end. That's when we turn our attention to the north. We'll have a cold front move in from the north. That'll bring our temperatures from the mid to upper 70s this week to the mid to upper 60s this weekend. So a cool down on the way, but it will come with a price. We'll see some clouds in place Saturday and Sunday. We should stay rain free though. That changes though as this cold front back toward the west, in part the same system giving Dallas all that rainfall, slowly starts to make it our way. Here's the catch, though. It stalls out just north of us, and as it does, we're going to see some rain showers move up with little areas of low pressure Tuesday into Wednesday of next week. So your weekend looking good. A great weekend to go out and check out the leaves that'll be especially prevalent up in the North Carolina mountains. We're talking mid to upper 60s with increasing clouds on Sunday. And after that's when the rain moves in. And we could use it for the North Carolina mountains behind about 2 inches for the GSP airport. We're working with a surplus of about 0.4 inches. Here's the 4-day plus. Look for sunshine in abundance over the next several days. Friday night football games looking great. We'll see warm afternoons and cool evenings. Then the clouds increase as we get into the weekend here with highs in the mid to upper 60s. Then the rain chances come back in Monday night, especially by Tuesday and Wednesday. We could see around 1 inch to 2 inches of rain over a course of about 3 days.